Good morning, church family. My name is Ryan McLaughlin, and this is my wife, Emily, and we are so excited to be worshiping with all of you this morning. We have been a part of First Pres's community for just about a year now, and we have just been so incredibly grateful to be a part of a church that truly prioritizes the young adult community and the community of young married couples and young families.
Yes, church, it is such an honor and a joy to be able to be with you this morning. When Ryan and I were first asked, how has God shown himself to us during this pandemic? There were three particular instances that came to our minds. The first being just quality time with loved ones. I think the busyness of our schedules oftentimes distracts us from truly valuing and prioritizing time with each other. And for Ryan and I being within our first year of marriage, we have just really realized the importance of quality time. And about a few weeks leading up to the pandemic, we had started diligently praying for quality time together. And man, God has shown up in immeasurable ways. And we are just so thankful for quality time together. We have it has just taught us so much about each other. It's taught us about our marriage, and most importantly, it's grown us closer with each other and the Lord. And we're thankful for that. I think another example is just how we need to slow down. And I think our world invites us to fill our schedules to their max capacity. And I think God is just telling us we need to slow down and we need to lean on Him. I think we didn't really know what real rest was until this season. And with that, we have been able to experience God's presence in a more full and just intimate way. And we're just thankful. We have seen Him in just the simple and ordinary things. And it has truly become more and more extraordinary through this time.
Yeah, and I think the third thing that we've noticed in a way in which God has revealed himself is just positioning our hearts to be more grateful. I think one thing that we were noticing in our prayer life prior to this pandemic taking place is we were focusing our prayers more on what we felt that we needed, and we're slowly transitioning our hearts into focusing more on praying for the things that we have to be thankful for and truly thanking God for those things. That can be as simple as praying for Thanksgiving for a roof over your head, or, you know, food to have to break bread with each other in the evening, or even Wi-Fi, to be able to have Wi-Fi and video capabilities to worship together as a church community. These are all blessings that God has given us that oftentimes get overlooked, but are truly just evidence of God working in and through all of our lives. And so throughout all of this, one of the things that, you know, we have just noticed is that God is continuing to show witness to us just how great he is and how much he has blessed us in our lives. And just really three things that Emily and I want to keep at the top of our priority list are, you know, just remembering to prioritize the things that are the most important to us and truly taking the time to and effort to do that. And also number two, being patient with all of those around us. Everyone is going through something different, but at the same time, we're truly all in the same boat. And number three being just to show God the gratitude that he deserves and to truly be grateful for all of the blessings that he's given us in our lives.
Yeah, and we want to encourage you as we continue to fight this pandemic together, which is some scripture. So this comes from 2 Corinthians 4:15, and it says, "For it is all for our sake, that as grace extends to more and more people, it may increase thanksgiving to the glory of God." We love you so much, church, and we're in this together.